What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing remote server administration tools, or RSAT for short, offline using MDT. So let's get right into it. Now, the first thing that we need to do is download the Feature on Demand ISO for the Windows operating system that you want to install these RSAT tools. Now, for me, I logged into my Microsoft Office 365. I went into my volume licensing. I did a search for feature and I located the version that I want. Now, the version that I want would be the Windows 11 languages and optional features. And I basically downloaded the feature that I want. Now, it's broken down by build. Now, you have to download the version that you're working with. For Windows 11, they got it broken down to Windows 11 version 22H2 or 23H2, or you could actually download 21H2. So just download the correct ISO. The ISO, I downloaded it into my MDT server. And if we open up the File Explorer and we go into downloads, there goes the ISO. This is Windows 11 22H2. Now, I've kind of found out that if you're deploying Windows 11 22H2, this ISO does not work. You actually have to use 21H2, which is weird. If you're deploying Windows 11 23H2, Windows 22H2 or 23H2 should work. It's weird, trust me. If you're deploying Windows 11 22H2, make sure that you're using the correct ISO. Now, rather than doing everything manually, basically mounting the ISO and then copying the files that you want to create this package, there are some PowerShell scripts that will help you out to do everything automatically. One PowerShell script is actually to copy the content within the Feature on Demand ISO file. And this is the PowerShell script right here. On the first command, it basically locates the ISO source for us, or for me. I downloaded and dropped it into the downloads folder. So it's going to grab that content there. The next command is basically going to mount the ISO and assign a drive letter. Most likely, it probably assigns F drive or E drive or whatever. For me, it was the F drive, and it took that drive letter and assigned it to $path. Now, the next command, we are basically defining our desired language, which for me would be English US. The next command is basically creating a folder within the temp folder, and it's going to be called RSAT. Underscore and whatever language you have. Now, for my language, it would be EN-US. So that's the name of the folder. The next command is basically going to grab everything inside the mounted ISO image, and it's going to grab everything within the AMD 64 cab, WAL 64 cab, AMD 64, and the language that you want cab, and then finally the WAL 64 and the language that you want cab file. It's also going to exclude a bunch of languages, features that you don't really need. We are just focusing on the RSAT tools. Now, the next two commands is basically copying the metadata folder over to the temp folder that we created. And then it's copying the feature on demand metadata underscore client cab file. It's going to move that over to the temp folder that we created. Now, the last command is basically dismounting the disk image. And then you're good to go. On the desktop, on my MDT server, we're going to open up the File Explorer. We're going to go into the C drive. We're going to go into the temp folder. And there goes the folder that was created within the PowerShell script, right? If we open it up, you're going to see all the cap files that we defined to grab from the disk image to bring it over to this folder. It also copied over the feature demand metadata underscore client file that we need, and as well as the metadata folder. If you open up that folder, you're going to see a bunch of cap files, and you need this for everything to work properly. Now, inside the root of this folder, I dropped a PowerShell script to install the cap files. We're going to open up this PowerShell script, and this is it right here. We're going to define the feature on demand source location, which would be .backslash. That is going to be the root of the folder. That's where all the cap files are located. We're also going to use Git Windows capability, and we're going to locate only the RSAT tools. And then last but not least, we're going to do a for each loop that's going to add all the features into the machine. Now, we're going to open up our MDT workbench because it is time for us to create our application. So within here, let's click on applications. We're going to right click on it. We're going to click on new application. I'm going to leave it as the default as application with source files. So we're going to click next here. Provide all the information that you want, but I'm going to provide the mandatory one, which is the application name. And this is what I gave it. I'm going to click next here. For the source directory, we're going to click browse. We're going to go into this PC. We're going to go into the C drive. We're going to click on temp and we're going to click our folder. Now, you're not using this destination. MDT is actually going to copy all the content within this folder and move it over into your deployment share. Once you're done selecting the folder, let's click OK. Click next here. I left the destination as the default. Click next. And this is where the magic happens. Now, the command that we need to do is the following. We need to use PowerShell.exe with a parameter of execution policy and set it to bypass. We're going to use another parameter of file, and then we're going to call our file that we just dropped inside that folder, which would be install-rsat-offline.ps1. Click next here. Nice little summary. Click next and complete it. Click finish. There goes our application. It is completed. Now let's get into the task sequences and pick your task sequence. For me, I'm going to select the BTNHD Windows 11 TS. TS stands for task sequence. We're going to right click on it. We're going to go into properties. And within here, let's go inside the task sequence tab. We're going to scroll down until we see the install applications. I'm going to change the name to the following. And once I do that, I'm going to select install a single application and I'm going to click on browse and I'm going to select our new package that we created together. Awesome. Click OK, click apply, click OK. Awesome. So I'm going to select my deployment share. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to select update deployment share. You're going to get the wizard. I'm going to leave everything as the default. Click next here. Nice little summary, click next, and we're done, and click finish. Now, don't go anywhere. I'm going to show you guys the whole process. I actually created a virtual machine. I pixie boot into my environment. I picked the task sequence that we made the modifications, and at the very end, you're going to see me kind of change the power settings because it kind of times out and it blacks out, so I had to change the power settings, but it installs everything, and it actually installs all the RSAT tools, which is pretty awesome. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.